In this screencast, we will conduct a stability analysis for a process being controlled by a PI controller. So the information is given on the screen. We have a second order process transfer function, a zeroth order valve transfer function, and a zeroth order sensor transmitter transfer function. And what we're trying to do here is determine what range of KC and tau I will allow the controller to be stable. KC and tau I individually each have effects on stability. So as KC, the controller gain, goes up, stability issues go up. So if increasing KC causes increase in stability issues, why would you ever increase KC? As KC goes up, the speed of your response also goes up. So therefore, there is a trade-off here between the performance from a speed standpoint of your response and whether or not your process will become unstable. Similarly, for tau I, there is the same effect, except only that for tau I, the issue occurs as tau I goes down. So as tau I goes down, we have the same issues where we have a better response in terms of the speed of the response. However, it is more susceptible to stability issues. So what it means is we have these two things happening independently, but when we put the two together in a PI controller, there is some symbiosis between the two of them, which means that you can't develop tuning parameters for a PI controller by doing the KC part by itself and the tau I by itself, because both of them are having similar or potentially opposing effects. So therefore, these need to be analyzed together. In order to conduct stability analysis, we're interested in the denominator of our transfer function, which can be represented by the characteristic equation, which states that 1 plus the open loop gain is 0. So therefore, that'll be 1 plus the transfer functions for the controller, the valve, the process, and the transmitter. So we have a PI controller here, so therefore that will have the transfer function KC times tau IS plus 1 over tau IS. The valve is given as a transfer function of 2. The process has a transfer function of 1 over S squared plus 2S plus 2. And the transmitter has a transfer function of 0.5. In order to carry out this analysis, we have to find the least common denominator. So that will be tau IS multiplied by S squared plus 2S plus 2. Our first term, the 1, needs to be multiplied by both of those terms that were just mentioned in the denominator. And the second term already has both of those. So all we have here is KC times 2 times a half times 1. So that will be just KC times tau IS plus 1. We will get rid of the denominator, and then we'll factor out. So when we factor out, we'll have tau IS cubed plus 2 tau IS squared plus 2 tau IS plus KC times tau IS plus KC equals 0. If we group the S terms together to clean this up just a little bit, we'll have our characteristic equation. So from here, we'll do a Routh analysis of the characteristic equation. And recall that a Routh analysis requires all coefficients to be positive and all terms in the first column of the array to be positive. So as we look at our system here, we can see that from the S cubed term and the S squared term, we end up with the same result, saying that tau I must be greater than 0. Additionally, if we look at the constant term, we see that KC must be greater than 0. The S term will not provide us much more information because we already know that tau I must be greater than 0, which dictates the fact that the 2 plus KC term must be also greater than 0. So if I look at the 2 plus KC, that would tell us the fact that KC would have to be greater than negative 2. But that range is superseded by the 1 for the constant term, that KC is greater than 0. So we'll construct our Routh array. For the terms in the characteristic equation, we start at the top left with the highest power term and work ourselves in a somewhat zigzag fashion as seen here. Because this is a third order transfer function, the only other value we need for our Routh analysis that will be of utility will be B1. And B1 is defined as a relationship between a variety of constants that are in the original characteristic equation. So recall that with a Routh array, the first term that you start with, the one with the highest power of S, gets the connotation A to the N. For this case here, will be tau I. So moving on from that, the an minus 1 term will be 2 tau I. The an minus 2 term will be 2 plus kc times tau I. And the an minus 3 term will be kc. There's 1 tau I in each of the terms in this equation, so we can cancel those out. And what this leaves us with is that b1 is going to equal 2 times 2 plus kc times tau I minus kc all over 2. In order for this process to be stable, this value must be greater than 0. So what we now want to do is evaluate this. And what we note here, unsurprisingly based on our earlier discussions, that the values of kc and tau I are coupled. We'll get rid of the 2, because if we move it over to the right-hand side, it'll go to 0. And we're left with 2 times 2 plus kc times tau I is greater than kc, if I move the kc over. If I divide to isolate tau I show that tau I must be greater than kc over, if I factor out, 4 plus 2 kc. This makes sense because tau I, in order for it to be stable, has to be larger than particular values. So therefore, the fact this is a greater than sign makes sense. We bring back our original criteria from our analysis of the constants, and we get our stability range here. So again, the important point to note here is the fact that the stability of this process is dependent on both kc and tau I. So in this screencast, we showed how to assess the stability of PI controllers and also to note and see the interaction effects that occur between the two parameters of a PI controller, kc and tau I.